All right, I'm taking a quick tea break. We're almost done shaping our form, and I like to take a minute just to relax and collect my thoughts before I move on. And if you get caught up in the turning and trying to rush, you're prone to make some mistakes and then just ruin the whole process. So I like to take a minute and just relax. Tea is great for that. So we're almost done shaping the outside. I want to flip it over and work on the top a bit. I'm happy with the shape. I added a raised feature that you might have seen, and we'll add a little texturing, maybe some carving to it, but I'm not sure yet. So we'll flip it over and keep going. Alrighty, here's our form. I decided at the last minute to add some beads here, which I think looks kind of neat. And a little lip here for the rim. And we'll do a little carving on there, I think. Maybe some texture up top. And next step is to core out the center with a Forstner bit so I can start hollowing. I think that I'm going to go with a smaller diameter bit, a smaller diameter mouth to this piece than I've used before, so we'll see how that goes. I might have to widen it up a bit later on if it's not working out for me, but I think it's gonna look pretty neat. I work in a pretty small space and I get a lot of dust floating around, so I recently decided to invest in some better lung protection, and so I got this Trend Air Shield Pro, and you know, it's got fans and circulates the air and filters the dust, supposedly. I haven't tried it yet, so I'm gonna try it on. Kind of big, a little bit bulky, about 2 pounds on the head, but hopefully it meets my needs and I'll turn it on. So you can see it circulates the air, doesn't fog up, seems like a pretty good system. So I'm going to try it out for the first time sanding today, and I'll let you know how it goes. So for my lid here, I'm going to use a technique that I learned indirectly from an artist named John Jordan, just from watching him work. I kind of figured out how to do it. So a lot of people think that I've been doing this with a Dremel tool, but it's actually with my power carver. So I'm going to take out the bit here and put in a little carbide bit. You can also use a drill bit, but for some reason I kind of like the texture that this leaves. So we're going to stick that in, and our carver has a reciprocating head that'll hammer little indentations into our piece and give a nice finish.